evening and welcome to Tinkering with Etkelar. For this episode, I can finally present the result of several weeks of poking and prodding to restore this little piece of retro computing history. A Commodore VIC-1520. A pen plotter made by Commodore for their 8-bit series of computers. Most commonly used for the C64 as a cheaper printer stand-in. Yes, originally, this plotter was cheaper than a printer. Back in the day, nobody around me had any fancy computer-to-paper interface device, so I was pretty surprised to hear that such a thing even existed. I did manage to grab one on, you might have guessed it, eBay. This one came complete with the original box even. Well used, but still, original packaging. Woohoo! Sadly though, there are some issues with it. The obvious one is that one of the paper holders is missing. Oh well, shouldn't be too hard to make one of those. I made an OpenSCAD model of the paper roll holder. They are mirrored versions, so I can use a -1 scale to create the other. I'm cutting them down in the middle to compensate for any warping in my 3D print. After printing and sanding, I glued the two halves together and spray painted them. And yes, I made two, so it wouldn't be as obvious that there is a replacement in there. Next, disassemble and clean, as usual, which means down to the last screw. The electronics got new capacitors, naturally, and were the quickest fix this time. The slightly more problematic issue are the little sprockets on the driving motors. These little buggers are apparently known to be broken, and my device is no exception. Let's see what happens here. The sprocket is made from a plastic of sorts, which gets press-fitted onto the motor shaft. Not a problem in itself, as many gears in small and/or cheap devices are plastic, and they can be quite sturdy. But plastics, especially this one, will shrink over time. The motor shaft, not so much. This inevitably leads to a nice crack in the gear. Gears. The larger one fare better since there is much more meat to them to compensate, but they also have tiny cracks. There are replacements available, but where is the fun in just ordering them? Well, you would of course have to find them before you start making your own version. For a very long time I tried to find gear cutters, but the smallest ones out there are still a few numbers too large for this microscopic gear. When I was making the replacement buttons for the spectrum analyzer, I thought, could I maybe cast the gear? And so I gave it a try. Before molding, I superglued the crack in the gear so it would be closer to its original shape. I made two molds, just to be on the safe side. Since I only have clear resin around from my sunken treasure project, I put in a dab of coloring. That should make it easier to identify problems in the teeth. The gears seem fine, but this resin takes ages to harden. It goes through a rubbery stage first. Still, it is thin enough to form nice, sharp gear teeth. And now, to drill the hole. To free the pull string from the frame, I had to open it up at the seam, which is essentially a type of pressed metal sleeve. I carefully cut it open so the string wouldn't get shorter in the process. The frame of the plotter mechanism is riveted together, so I'll leave those parts. They might not go together again precisely or stable enough if I take them apart. And here's where I discovered the third issue. The print head, which holds the four colored pens, has a tiny little metal spring on the front that pushes the pens away from the paper and is overcome by the pen down mechanism on the backside. Problem with it? There was a chunk missing. The plotter wouldn't work properly without that, or at least not with all four pens. Another spare part to remake. To model the spring, I used OpenSCAD again. It does support my way of thinking in three dimensions very well. Project the shape as an outline, export and create a G-code file for the mill. Nice and simple. I had one of those engraving CNC mills on my wanted tool list for quite some time, and this seemed the best opportunity to actually get one. Again, on a budget, I picked the lower cost model. I might be putting up an assembly video later, if I can find that memory card again. I then used a piece of 1/10mm steel to mill out the shape in several iterations. The cutter isn't really designed for steel, so I ran the program several times until the cutter broke through on some locations and cleaned up the rest with a pair of small pliers and fine sandpaper. I fully expected this to be a trial run only, and was truly surprised by how well it fit on the printhead. A bit of sanding later, and I'm in business. Putting the mechanism together again, after having it apart for almost a month, was a bit challenging. I had to refer back to my footage several times to make sure that all the parts go into the right location. To reconnect the pull string, I used the smallest ferrule I had in my box and squeezed it shut over the end of the string. Most of the force is taken up by the bend in the string anyway, so this should hold up fine. Next issue. The vertical movement, that is the paper transport, has a set of spring-loaded opposing gears to cut down on the backlash. Nice idea, but the attachment point of the spring has broken off, so the spring is useless by now. I bent a replacement and glued the end of it to one gear so it wouldn't come loose. Not perfect, but serviceable. The plastic parts are starting to annoy me. Thank you. the new sprockets fit nicely and turn free. I should have drilled the holes a smidge smaller. Oh well, a dab of super glue to the rescue. I can scrape that off the shaft if I need to replace them. And now, after all this work, will it move correctly? Will it plot? Tune in next week to find out. Nah, just kidding. I loaded up the 4 pens. Yes, you can still buy those new. Put in some paper and turned on the plotter. Woohoo! It moves! But the pens don't write on the paper. Turns out that my spring steel is slightly too thick or too stiff. It would have been better to go with a slightly softer material. But hey, a bit of bending later, and later, and later, I finally have satisfying results. Time to put the plotter to a test. I wonder what I could plot. With the LEGO Plotter HPGL converter, I wrote a quick program that converts an HPGL file into a simple C64 basic program that will send the line commands to the plotter. Copy and paste into VICE and save to a disk image, then hop over to the real deal with the floppy emulator and load the program and run it. Okay, 3, 2, 1, go! Run! Okay, my coordinate system seemed to be messed up. The first print came out mirrored. Take two. And that's it for this episode. I promise the next video will not involve a plotter. See you then! The gears seem fine, but this ages takes resin to harden. What?